Hey everybody, welcome to the next commentary, playing Lilia mid lane versus Swain this game. This is a normal game, no idea what the ranks are, as usual, pinned comment. And also, to address some comments, because obviously some people like, or really dislike the low elo content. I mean, basically a month ago I posted something about like, hey, I was just wondering, why you guys think maybe my view count is down. Because, I was just getting less views than normal for basically the same exact high elo content. But, almost every single time that I ever play a different champion, it always does better than every single high elo content that I've ever done. Unless it has, like, double lift or something inside of it, where I could, like, use his name to get more views. So basically, smurfing content always does better than high elo content. Every single time. So, am I gonna stop doing high-elo content? No, I mean, I actually really enjoy playing high-elo content. Low-elo content definitely is... It's good in its own way. It actually shows a ton of mistakes that otherwise you can't show inside of high-elo, and it's more relatable to the viewer because most people watching just... There's a percentile of challenger players, obviously, so if you're playing only versus challenger players, it's not gonna be very relatable. But... Basically, you know, if you really hate the low elo content, just if it's gonna be a champion that is not meta, it's probably gonna be a low elo video and just don't click on it. Also, I'll be publishing high elo because I actually still am competitive and I enjoy playing it. But today I played 4 games of high elo, and the closest game that maybe could have been a video just had a bunch of people literally just freaking out at each other, and it's just frustrating and annoying to basically play with. So okay, let's hit him with EQ. The thing is that I actually have pretty decent consistent damage with auto attacks, so even though he got good burst off, we still like managed to hit him. Oh, really nice hit. Oh, he didn't E back though. That's alright though. Hit him again. I'm getting kind of low, so I can't mess up again. If he hits me with, like, another... E? It could be really bad. Okay, we got him. We bopped him. Oh, wait, am I dead? No way, right? Okay, Talon's bot, so we're safe. Or top. He's somewhere. Talon's not mid, because he killed my team, so... We can probably shove this out. I just use my W on top of him, so he has to flash it, otherwise he dies. He probably didn't realize the damage. Not many people play Lilia mid in the first place. It deals 250 damage. It was easy to land because I recently slowed him. So I just knew my damage potential better than he did. So we got a nice free kill. We're probably going to be going Riftmaker. I think it's the best Lilia build. I mean, you can also go Liandry's as well, but I really like the Riftmaker because eventually you can get to the point where you're just, like, super tanky and also getting a lot of Omnivamp and just running at people. So. Also, if you guys really want to see high-elo content, but it's not, like, commentary, all of my stream, when I stream on Twitch, I only play high elo. I never play norms. I don't even play ARAMs with my viewers. I literally only... all I do is play ranked. That's all I do. I'm gonna just step up, hit him, auto attack, see if I can land the center of it. Didn't land. It's not the easiest. One more Q and then back away. And then we walk back in because he might overstep, and then we can go again. Just auto attack. I'm actually okay here. Don't let him get the third hit on me, and then just continue trading. One more Q. Probably can't kill. If he stays in lane here, I can kill. He shouldn't stay in lane. He should have just based. Because I can Q flash. Okay, yeah, he left. That's the thing about this champion is, I have such high movement speed, especially because I rush level 2 boots, so when I got a really good trade-off on Swain, I just turned around and then basically re-engaged as soon as my Q came off cooldown, which is, you know, instantly, right? So then he just can't play. Just sidestep that, Q again, auto attack, auto attack. The thing is I can kill him with one more Q. So I Q flash auto attack and I think I deal enough. So that's the plan right now. And that's just knowing the damage perfectly. Why we need to do it immediately is because he could turn level 5 there and then I cannot kill him. But even with champions that you don't play often, I guess getting a feel for how much damage you deal as you fight is kind of important. I don't do it anymore, but in the past, when I really was like grinding hard, I would basically think about the almost exact amount of damage I would deal in my head instead of just instinct it. Right now, I'm just instincting it, like how much damage I deal, but I was actually thinking about it. Now, at this point, we're so fed that just landing ultimate should kill him, right? That's all we need to do. The wave is shoving towards us as well, so I could actually just not touch the wave if I want to really make it, like, even more annoying for him. Some people would just immediately shove this out and then not know what to do with the lead, so let's try to make it so we can get more kills. How about that? You can hit me with stuff. I don't mind. Because all I'm doing is just letting you shove in, because now you're screwed. So I'll just last hit and see if I ever land an E. I will kill one creep with my Q. I'm positioning myself, so I'm like barely killing the wave just to get the movement speed ramp. And then as soon as he steps up here, we can look. And then back away, right? And I'll ulti if he steps back up, but he didn't step back up. But that's the plan. Eventually he has to step up. That's the thing. What else are you supposed to do? You're already screwed, right? So I'll just ulti now because of where he's positioned. Just bop him on the head, auto attack. We don't even need to use ignite here because he has no flash from earlier. It's basically like playing as if I'm Irelia, right? Irelias will freeze the wave on you, and then they'll just immediately engage on you when you are stepping up to try to fix the wave. If you're wondering what he could do to fix it, honestly, the only thing he can do is call his jungler and hope that they don't get 1v2 because of how fed I am. That's about it. That's literally it. So we'll go buy. I can buy... I was going to say, I didn't know I already had a Dark Seal. I was going to buy this plus a Dark Seal, but I already have it. Alright, I guess we're just chilling on this then. I really enjoy playing Lilia. It's actually a really entertaining champion to play. And I was going to say that like I also picked Lilia intentionally because I feel like she's a difficult champion to win with inside of lane. You actually have to play it pretty smart. But now that we already have a lead, I don't really have to play as smart anymore. I can kind of just brute force it. I can freeze it again. So once again, he just has to fix it somehow, but he probably can't. The issue with doing this is my team is actually losing in some lanes, and this makes it so it's more difficult to just leave the lane, because I'll actually miss creeps if I do that, because this wave, his wave will shove under my tower and start dying. So the disadvantage to me doing this is that I'm just basically ignoring my team. He could also leave lane and go roam, by the way. But normally when mid laners do that, they get punished more than others. Alright, let's just fight him. Back away. We'll just ulti. I bought Talon on the head. One more Q kills. That's the thing. They can't even 1v2 me because I'm just too tanky. I full tanked the whole entire Talon combo. Did no damage. Lilia, if you didn't know her passive, restores HP over time, so I think I hit both of them there with it, so I was just regening a lot. Wow, Taric triple kill. Wait, this Taric is so fed. He has a 400 gold shutdown. Just the Taric. Not even the Samira. Alright, so we're just gonna base. We need to eventually help out our team. You know, it seems like a, oh my gosh, this is such a stomp. Actually, we're behind in kills right now, believe it or not. Even though I have 6. I'm going to immediately buy this. And I'm going to basically risk the entire game for this book. If we kill him once, we go up to 10 and we get the bonus movement speed. Before then, this item actually sucks. This is actually a terrible purchase because it actually doesn't build into anything and it doesn't even have that many stacks. Let's just throw an E and see if it sticks. Oh. Even if it hit, it doesn't really matter. I have double buffs, by the way. That feels pretty good. Samira and Taric might eventually roam mid. Like, right now. Because they're not bought, which is odd. They should be bought. So there's a chance that they are sitting behind this guy, waiting for me to engage on him, but I'm not. I'm just going to roam top here. There's a chance they also went top. They could be anywhere. Okay, they're back bot. We see them. This guy is not running away, so he should just be a free kill, because he's so far away from safety, aka his tower, that he shouldn't really be able to escape. He's just going for the Graves kill. Oh my gosh. 30 HP there. He hit him with the GP passive, but it just didn't deal enough. Okay, we go bowling. We go bowling. Just auto attack. I'll wait for him to start running away before bopping his head. I'm actually healing for a lot. I don't know how easy it would be to actually kill this guy under tower. I just W it. Ah, oh, dang. I was hoping he would Q the minion, but he didn't. I was trying to make him Q the minion, and then I Q him. Oh! Q that one? Hey, I knew you would do that one at least. Dang, if I ignited him, he might have died. He might be over this wall? Huh? Oh. I missed. Oh, wait, what? You're still here. Oh no, your jump! Your parkour! Alright, he's just a amateur stunt artist, not a professional, clearly. New to the job, new to the job. Oh, my bot lane actually managed to kill the Taric. Big shutdown. Oh, they killed both. Nice. Okay, so, let's go buy. Every single time I have ultimate, I can kill this guy. I mean, even without ultimate, I can kill him. So. When you're this far behind, and even before this, the biggest mistake... the biggest mistake is basically stepping up afterwards, but I mean, there's not really much he can do. Can he fight this guy? They're both level 8, by the way. Oh my gosh. Swain just sucked him down, bro. Quinn died top. I have my item. It's pretty nice. I think I want my blue buff. Or our blue buff. My team's blue buff. I actually run out of mana pretty damn quick. There are different ways of playing Lilia. I could go for like a, I could go for Frozen Heart. I really want to go bot. I bet they're going to fight soon. We'll just use ultimate here. Why not? Oh, this guy might be dead too. It's like right here. Oh, I missed that. I should never miss that. Dang. Use these golems? There's no golems available. Where did he go? Oh, there he is. Just speed myself up. Is it Talon? I mean, not Talon, Swain. I don't want to use my flash. Okay, I'll rotate this way. Oh, he's dead. Yeah, died to my passive. The thing is that it's easy to tell when people are playing aggressive enough that they're probably going to start fighting soon. Firstly, they're fed. Secondly, they're pushing up really far in the wave, and also it looked like they were contesting the wave. So like, my team was literally being pressured past their own wave. Like, the Taric and Smear were running past my teammate's wave just to try to hit them. So basically it just means that, oh, okay, these guys will probably be interested in fighting if my team sees that I'm coming down and they step up to basically bait them in. That's why I do the on the wave pings, so they know. We'll just kill him under tower. There's nothing really he can do at this point. It's too far behind. Oh. Go this way. Man, if only it was a different jungler, that would be easier to catch. Oh, we go bowling for talent? Oh, never mind. Alright, what do I want to buy? A Rylai's just to be annoying? A Frozen Heart, just because they're basically full AD. Let's try Frozen Heart for now. This is like the safe pick. Oh, does my team die? Oh, that's okay. So these guys might go for tower, despite them not probably needing to. If I can land this here on anything, even minions. All right. The thing is that we're starting to start our... We'll just queue him. We'll go this way because he's trying to run. Oh, wait. I didn't see you. Oh, that was a good juke, actually. I don't think you're able to juke this one, though. that was actually a pretty impressive juke. Swain. Pull me. Oh! Okay, never mind. I'm not fast enough. Oh, okay. You want to give me it? There. Oh, I hit you. Do I want to ult you, though? Probably not, right? Talon. You're dead. Passive deals a decent amount of dot damage, so I just knew that he couldn't get away. We'll just ulti all three of them. Just keep on weaving in and out of tower aggro. How tower aggro works is when you reset it, it will reset the damage. Okay, whatever, I died. So every single time, that doesn't include swapping aggro. So as an example, Blitzcrank tanked 3 autos, and then if I was under tower next, that would be 4 auto attack ramping, right? But what happens is Blitzcrank tanked, I ran out of tower aggro, and he did. Tower has no one. I run back in, it resets to 1 again. So basically you want to go in and out of tower aggro over and over again if you can. With Lilia, is probably one of the champions that actually can do this like the most effectively out of anybody else. But yeah, just constantly running back to reset the tower aggro over and over so it's not really dealing that much damage to me. But I got stunned by Taric there, which is why I died. If I only killed him a bit faster, maybe we could have been able to survive. When you're fed on Lilia, and you have your stacks going, you have huge outplay potential. It is so difficult to catch you. He could be backing right here, possibly. I was just checking. This guy's playing aggressive again. I'm just going to start rotating to it because they're still playing aggro. Like, look how far up they are inside the lane. The synths? Yeah, okay, nice. That hit. Just because he's slowed, we auto win. You can see that she's just leaving this guy behind because she knows that she can't do anything. I can still go, though. You? By the way, you can spell shield that. So she could have survived it if she really wanted to. I missed my Q here, but it's whatever. Oh, it's not whatever. It's not whatever. It's not. Okay, nice. Lilia ulti is a projectile, so Samira can actually wind wall it. So can Yasuo. So if she used her W as I ult, she can actually cancel it, but she doesn't realize that. I don't think she knows. A lot of people don't know. It's similar to, like, Vex E is also a skill shot, if you didn't know. The thing that looks like a Gragas barrel. No, it's not like a Gragas barrel. Anyways, Vex E looks like it's an instant cast, like something disappears on the ground, a little circle. It actually is a skill shot that can be windballed. There's some things that look like they shouldn't be skill shots, but they are. I can just go in. I'm trying to keep my stacks up, though. Okay, so they're bot, so I'm actually safe enough that I think I can just literally walk in. I think he's dead. Yep. I'm just gonna sit in their base until literally all of them come to kill me at this point. Okay, not everybody. They're just still pushing bot. No. Fine, I will literally farm all three waves then. Fine. Okay, maybe two waves. It might be hard to get all three of them coming. I got two waves. This is fine. Stop pushing bot. Come back. Please. Hello, Swain. Welcome back. Dodge the GP barrel. Hit this one. Hit that one. Walk in. Oh, I should have landed that. That guy's dead. Get those guys. Just dodge that. This guy has no flash. It's going in and out of tower aggro. Oh, you got me. You did it. I could not tank six. I was already too low. I could not tank more. Cosmic Drive sounds kind of nice, but I'm pretty sure the game should maybe be over. Oh, they FF'd. Well, anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, drop a like or a comment below about your favorite part or anything you might have learned. It just helps me with the algorithm so I can try to grow my channel. And yeah, I mean, sorry for... I mean, I would imagine if you really dislike it so much, you probably wouldn't even make it to this part of the video, so I don't know why I would say sorry, because you're probably not even here. But anyways, sorry for people who don't like low elo content. For some reason, it does better. I don't even know why. I feel like high elo content should do better, but it's also because there's a champion pool. I can't play Lily mid inside high elo. I will basically be griefing my team and also just lose. I'm sure I could play inside a diamond, but... Anyways, once again, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And I will see you guys next time.